Since you're here, I assume you've recently run into the same problem a friend of mine recently did while trying to pair his Quest 2 with the Meta Quest app on his phone, where no matter what you do, the app will not pair with your headset. I'm also going to assume you've tried all the basic troubleshooting steps like rebooting your Quest and uninstalling and reinstalling the app to your phone. If you've tried that stuff and possibly even more, for example, factory resetting your Quest and or sideloading the latest firmware to your headset and it still won't pair, then what I'm about to show you in this video may just be the solution to your problem. Before we get started, I need to let you know this is a workaround that bypasses the mobile app. It does get your headset usable, where you can play games on it and stuff again, but it does not fix the pairing problem with the mobile app. So while you will be able to game on your headset, you will not be able to adjust settings or anything from within the app. I just want to make sure that's perfectly clear. All right, to get your headset back into working order again, there's a few things we're going to need. First, we need a PC or laptop with Bluetooth capability. And second, if you don't have one already, you're going to need a Meta Quest Devloper Account. If you don't have one, don't worry about it. Setting up a developer account is actually really simple. You just go to developer.oculus.com/manage, and here it will prompt you to log into your Meta Quest account. You'll then need to register as a developer by first entering the name of your organization in this field. You can make this pretty much whatever you want, and it will tell you if a name you've input is already in use, meaning you'll have to come up with something else. Once you've got your organization name figured out, check this I understand box and then click submit. Now what I'm about to show here was all done on this Quest 2, which had been factory reset. So if you're having trouble pairing the mobile app with a headset that has not been factory reset, I don't know for sure how this is going to go for you, but since you're here watching this, odds are you've already factory reset your Quest in an effort to get the mobile app to pair with it. So we're probably in the same boat here. Anyway, back to the tutorial. Now we need to go to Google and search for Meta Quest Developer Hub. We want this link right here that says Meta Quest Developer Hub Unity. We'll then scroll down to install MQDH right here, and if you're on Windows like me, you'll click on the Windows link and then this big blue download button. Once it's finished downloading, we'll need to extract the files by right-clicking on the zipped folder and clicking on Extract All. We now need to double click on this Meta Quest Developer Hub file to install the application. And once it has installed, as long as you leave this box checked, when you click Finish, you will be launched into the Developer Hub application. Here we'll click on Continue, and then we need to log into our Meta account. Once you're logged in, you want to go up to Device Manager here in the upper left, and then click on Setup New Device. Now, before we go any further, you're going to want to make sure your developer account has been verified. We can do this by clicking on this link right here. And if you aren't logged into your account, it will prompt you to log in. I'm already logged in, so it went straight to this page for me. I've already verified my account, so I'm good to go here. But if your account has not yet been verified, then you're going to need to complete one or more of these things down below and verify your account before moving on. Switching over to our Quest 2. Since this headset was factory reset, I needed to go through the initial setup stuff and get my friend's headset connected to my Wi-Fi. For those of you in the same boat here, you'll be very familiar with this screen, as it's where all progress stops. When you go to the mobile app and input your pairing code, you see nothing but this message saying, "Unable to connect to your headset." This is where we go back to our computer and the Meta Quest Developer Hub. With our headset powered on and our developer account verified, we are now going to click Next right here. It will then ask us what device we're setting up. In my case, it's a Quest 2, and at this screen, it will display any Quest headsets nearby we have powered on. Click on your headset and the next button once again. This process does take a little bit of time to complete, but it should only last a minute or so, so just be patient. Once you see this screen, you're almost there. Click on Next to sign into your account, and the next thing that should pop up is this screen asking which Wi-Fi network you want to connect your headset to. Select the network you want, and then click Next yet again. We then need to click on this toggle button here to enable developer mode on our headset, which then allows us to click the button to go to the next screen where we see our connection has been successful. Click Next one last time, and now we can click on Finish. With that done, we can put our headset back on, and now instead of the screen asking us to put in our pairing code, we should see this. We can now create our boundary, finish the setup process, and use our headset as normal once again. Like I said at the beginning of the video, unfortunately, this does not fix the pairing problem with the mobile app. So you won't be able to adjust your headset settings or pair different controllers with your headset or any of those kinds of things from the mobile app. I don't know if it's gonna happen, but hopefully Meta gets this figured out sometime soon and we won't have to rely on workarounds like this for very long. If this video helped you out, please drop a like on it, share with your friends, and subscribe to the channel. And if you're feeling especially generous, super thanks are a great way to show your appreciation and help me continue making content like this and more.